Good evening, Angelinos. I'm your mayor, Eric Garcetti, and I want to welcome you to the Greater Los Angeles Zoo Association's virtual Beastly Ball. Beastly Ball is our favorite event each year, and I know tonight you've gathered to celebrate the best zoo in America, our incredible cultural institution, a place where Angelinos and visitors alike learn about wildlife and are immersed in nature. For over 50 years, the LA Zoo has been dedicated to saving and protecting wildlife, which is what makes tonight and your support so important. Your support of the Beastly Ball will allow GLAZA to continue their fundraising efforts on behalf of the zoo. This has been such a challenging, traumatic year, and I want to take a moment to acknowledge the zoo and all the caretakers here who remain committed throughout the pandemic to animal welfare and to saving animals from extinction. Thank you from the bottom of my heart to Denise Verrett, our amazing CEO and zoo director, and Tom Jacobson, president of GLAZA, for your outstanding leadership. And congratulations to tonight's honorees, Jackie Chan and Leila George. There are better days ahead, we know that. And with the zoo reopening and welcoming guests back, I encourage you to visit the amazing animals and enjoy the incredible experiences that only the LA Zoo can offer. But for tonight, I encourage you, bid and help make this year's Beastly Ball a success until we can be back together again. Thank you, here's to great days ahead, and have a wonderful evening.
Time to go see me the animals up at the zoo. I wanna go there with you. Monkeys, koalas, and eagles all up in the tree. I see them looking at me. If it wasn't for the LA Zoo, some animals would be extinct. Lion, I can hear it loud. I can hear all the chimpanzees and I see giraffe necks way up high. I hear the black bear when it growl. Zebra stripes, reptiles, pink flamingos dressed in style. See the kangaroo when he bounce, bounce. Get ready for the countdown. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
I look around.
What do I see?
What do I see?
I see a face and it was made for you and me. Right here, right now.
It's perfect timing.
We're going to the LA Zoo. I said, come on, everybody.
I look around.
What do I see?
What do I see?
I see a face and it was made for you and me. When I need to be brave and I can't find it in me, I pretend that I'm a lion in the zoo. And though I'm small sometimes, I still feel I'm gigantic. Cause I pretend that I'm an elephant in the zoo. Which animal are you? Which animal are you? Which animal are you?
4, 3, 2, 1.
I look around. What do I see?
What do I see?
I see a face and it was made for you and me. Right here, right now.
It's perfect timing.
We're going to the LA Zoo. I said, come on, everybody.
I look around.
What do I see?
What do I see?
I see a face and it was made for you and me.
Welcome to the Greater Los Angeles Zoo Association's virtual Beastly Ball.
Hello, everyone. Thank you for joining us for this year's virtual Beastly Ball. I'm Tom Jacobson, president of the Greater Los Angeles Zoo Association.
And I'm Denise Verrett, chief executive officer and zoo director of the Los Angeles Zoo. Tom, can you believe that we're here together again, broadcasting virtually from the same location inside the Living Amphibians, Invertebrates, and Reptile Building as we did last spring? And correct me if I'm wrong, But are you wearing the same shirt as last year?
Indeed I am, Denise. Not everyone was the biggest fan of this shirt. Joel McHale threatened to burn it. But clearly, this shirt is lucky, because last year's Beastly Ball was such a huge success. Not only did we have more than 21,000 viewers from 40 states and 16 countries tune in, but we raised over $1 million. And I'm feeling even luckier tonight. In all seriousness, I know it's not the shirt. It's all of you. Because without you, we would not be able to make Laza strong so that we can provide the zoo with critical funds to support their mission to save animals from extinction and provide a safer place in our community for all to have a relationship with nature.
It's hard to believe that a year ago, the COVID-19 pandemic was a declared crisis. We have all been impacted by the pandemic, and despite the challenges, with Glaza's incredible support, we have stood tall and remained committed to the zoo and its mission, and also supported those in the community most in need. Our foundation for success is grounded in our vision, mission, and values, and I believe that our future is very bright. I am extremely grateful for the hard work and dedication of the staff and all the support we have received over the last year, and look forward to the collective impact we will have on wildlife through broad and diverse engagement of all communities that make up the great city of Los Angeles.
There is no doubt that I am inspired daily by the dedication, commitment, and flexibility that both the zoo and Glaza staff have exhibited this year. This spring, we launched our first virtual walkathon, Walk for the Wild, to bring awareness to the conservation work of the LA Zoo. And none of this would have been possible without the unwavering support of our Board of Trustees, our members, our donors, and all of you. Thank you all.
Tonight, you're going to hear about how our commitment to animal care and welfare, the One Health Initiative, and our Conservation Strategic Plan all work together to further the mission of the zoo under a banner of equity and environmental justice. We are not daunted by the significant challenges that we have faced over the last year. Rather, tonight, we celebrate resilience, recovery, and our optimistic future, where people and wildlife thrive together.
It's a big night with big ideas, big goals, big auction items, and even bigger talent. So Denise, let's raise a glass of champagne in celebration and let's get on with the show. Take it away, Joel.
Here we go, guys. Thank you. Thank you. Here we go. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. Wow. Thank you. Wow. Thank you, Denise and Tom, and welcome, everyone, to the Los Angeles Zoo's virtual Beastly Ball, now in its second socially distanced year. Oh, thanks. Oh, thanks, Kevin. I'm Joel McHale, joining you live from within the beautiful LA Zoo, where, due to my own confusion over Los Angeles County's quarantine rules, I have been living full-time since hosting last year's event. Sure, I've missed my family, but I've grown very close to the lemurs. Not the langurs, though. Those guys, they don't like me. I think it's my musk. It's very pungent. Thank you so much for joining us to support this amazing place, even though it meant you had to once again stare at Tom's confusing and terrifying shirt. Why, Tom? Why? We have an exciting, exciting show for you tonight, filled with inspiring stories from our LA Zoo staff, behind-the-scenes glimpses at your favorite animals, and exclusive performances from some of the biggest names in rock. And on top of all of that, we will be joined later by a special avian guest star, which is a fancy way of saying, we got a cool bird surprise. Plus, we'll host an auction full of amazing items, including our first ever art auction featuring the work of an eclectic mix of celebrity, local, and international artists, all of whom have contributed sculpture, paintings, prints, and photographs. And this is exciting. We'll auction off a one-of-a-kind piece by acclaimed painter Joel McHale. That's right, the man who art critics have hailed as the master of light, the modern Picasso, and that one guy from TV. I will create a painting during tonight's show, live and in real time, that you can bid on, take home, and proudly display in your garage, tucked behind some bags of mulch and Christmas decorations. If you simply must get your hands on this one-of-a-kind masterpiece, then head to bidpal.net/beastlyball2021 and look for item number 185 in the art category. Throughout the show, I'll highlight some other truly great live auction items, so stay tuned and keep bidding in that auction to win some amazing experiences that I haven't personally slathered in paint. You can also make a general donation, which the lemurs tell me they would very much appreciate, or give to the Fund a Need projects. These are all ways you can show your support for the Greater Los Angeles Zoo Association and the LA Zoo. We'll be checking in on our fundraising total throughout the night, of course. Last year, you helped raise more than $1 million. Thank you so much. And we want to do even better than that this year. Otherwise, the Langers may never let me leave. They really, really don't like my smell. I think it's because I also couldn't stop making fun of their shirts. We have a great show planned for you tonight. We hope you'll laugh, we hope you'll cry, two things people usually do around me anyway, and we hope you'll reach into your pockets and show your support. So, now grab a drink and a lemur, get comfortable, and settle in for an amazing show.
Hey everyone, Charlie Sheen here again. Welcome back to the second annual Virtual Beastly Ball, and hopefully, most certainly, the last Virtual Beastly Ball. Anyway, this year I'm not just hanging with the llamas. This year, I brought this guy, legendary actor Martin Sheen, and my human teleprompter.
Legendary actor Martin Sheen and human teleprompter and dad.
And dad, yes, yes. Anyway, as I was saying, we are so excited to be here. We're so excited for all of you to have shown up and lent your energy and
your support last year meant that the work of the zoo continues in challenging.
Your support last year meant that the work of the zoo continues in challenging times.
And we need you again, especially as the zoo is making up for the loss of visitors.
We need you again, especially as the zoo is making up for the loss of visitors.
This past year. We have all your favorite memories of visiting the LA Zoo.
That's not what it says. Oh, we all have favorite memories of visiting the LA Zoo.
That
says share some of yours.
Share one of yours.
I was nearly murdered holding my infant daughter by a silverback gorilla. It was a 2-inch piece of plexi. That's the reason that I'm standing here today.
Wow, and it's still there.
It's still there, yes.
To wrap it up here.
Yeah, right. Thank you for making
a difference
tonight.
And bid in the silent auction. Especially
the first ever art auction. Even if it's stuff you don't really need and have no plans of hanging on any wall in your house.
Now, where are those llamas? Love watching the ball with those guys.
Love watching the ball with those guys.
That's the end. Thanks so much. All the best.
Have a great night.
And now, your first animal ambassador moment.
Hi, this is Brian at your Los Angeles Zoo. I'm part of the ambassador team. And this here is Ursula. Ursula is an eastern indigo snake. This is a snake that you find in North America. They are North America's largest snake. So Ursula is not a venomous snake, and she's also not a constrictor. She actually is much more active when she hunts. Ursula was confiscated. She was residing with an individual who had a number of illegal snakes, and because of that could no longer care for any of those snakes. They were confiscated. Our snakes play a really special role in our ambassador program because a lot of people have a fear of snakes. And what we've found is that oftentimes, the more you learn about an animal, the less you're actually going to be afraid of these snakes if you do come across them in the wild. Again, always give them a nice wide space and respect them from a distance. But by having these snakes here, we're actually able to give people an up close and personal look at these animals. In some cases, even being able to touch or feel them. And that helps to demystify them and actually make them less scary.
Hi, this is Laker legend Robert Ory with a friendly reminder. If you haven't started bidding in the silent auction, get going. There are some incredible one-of-a-kind items to choose from this year. Bid and help support our LA Zoo.
And now, an episode of Just Ask Beth.
Do snakes take baths? snakes do take baths. It's really important for snakes to be able to take a bath. It helps them shed their skin when they're ready. And sometimes snakes go in the water to poop.
Which animal has the stinkiest fart?
I think the animals with the stinkiest farts are the ones that eat fish.
What animal really smells?
What animals smell?
Yeah.
Well, every animal smells, but they all smell different. And some smell good and some don't smell very good at all.
Which one makes the biggest poo?
Who makes the biggest poo? That's a really good question. I bet you can guess who makes the biggest poo. Who do you think it is?
The elephants.
Yeah, the elephants.
Hi, I'm Mindy Kaling. Did you know that collectively, zoos are the third largest global funder of direct conservation, providing hundreds of millions of dollars to support conservation organizations around the world each year?
Hey everyone, Ed Helms here. Did you know that the LA Zoo has an animal called a binturong? Yeah, I didn't either. Binturongs also are called bear cats, but that's kind of misleading because they're not related to bears or cats. In fact, they just look like giant dust mops and they smell like a freshly made batch of popcorn. In other words, it is the most random little creature in the world. And the LA Zoo has one, which is super cool. Please support the zoo tonight.
Hello, I am Beth Schaefer, Director of Animal Programs. Animal welfare has always been and has remained our number one concern here at the Los Angeles Zoo. Our animal care and animal health staff remain committed to this throughout the closure. We are very lucky to have the support of the great city of Los Angeles, and during these difficult days, none of our food or supply deliveries were interrupted. Our dedicated animal care and animal health teams came to work every day, donned the appropriate personal protective equipment, and modified procedures to ensure that our standards of animal care and welfare never wavered and that our animals were kept safe. The pandemic has not stopped us from always striving to create better welfare for the animals that call your Los Angeles Zoo home. In keeping with the AZA's standard of continuous improvement, we revised and furthered our animal welfare program with updated standards for evaluating the welfare of every animal in our care. We have also worked to empower every staff member to be a steward for animal welfare. Each staff member, from the director to our learning and engagement team to our grounds maintenance team, helped to keep a watchful eye on our animals. With 2,200 animals, it definitely takes a village. Probably the most common questions I've received during the closure are how have the animals reacted and did they miss people? Our guests are part of the everyday lives of the animals here. We noticed that when we would walk through the empty public spaces, many of the animals would approach the front of their habitats and often vocalize as we went by. And if you are a regular visitor to our Campo Gorilla Reserve, you may know Evelyn, our senior female in our family group. Evelyn makes it very clear that guests are her enrichment, and she was on hand in her favorite window spot when we welcomed guests back to the zoo, watching and interacting with them. So yes, they missed you. But during quieter times, we had no shortages of babies born. Over 75 births occurred this last year, including bighorn sheep, Francois Langer, Pudu, red-billed blue magpies, and of course, our signature conservation breeding programs, mountain yellow-legged frogs and California condors, increasing critical populations as we continue to save animals from extinction. The world-class standards of care that we are able to maintain here at the Los Angeles Zoo are in large part due to the support of you, our donors and fans. We can't tell you how much we appreciate your belief in us and our mission. We can't do it without you. Enjoy your night, and we hope to see you in person at the zoo soon.
I have had so many incredible experiences at the LA Zoo, I don't know where to start. I mean, from my early childhood, it felt like the zoo was my backyard. And I used to go to the zoo so excited, knowing that the animals couldn't wait to see me. And I get there kind of like, hey, I know you've been waiting for me. And then I got a little bit older and I realized, you know, they're not actually waiting to see me specifically. And then I got a little bit older than that and I realized they were really waiting to see me. I also used to go, my wife loves the zoo. We would go on her birthday to the zoo. And maybe one of the fun things for people who remember the Meerkat Manor exhibit, I was actually the narrator for Meerkat Manor on Animal Planet for three seasons, I think. And I remember coming to the LA Zoo to the Meerkat exhibit to study them very closely so I could get inside of the spirit of the Meerkats. And with their permission, I think I did.
Hi, I'm Ben Feldman. I hope you guys are enjoying this year's virtual Beastly Ball. If you haven't started bidding on the silent auction. I don't know what you're waiting for. There's a lot of really, really great stuff, including an art auction this year. So that's really cool. Oh, also, for the first time in his career, Joel McHale has agreed to not demand a large portion of your charitable donations be used towards his hosting fee.
Auction alert. Auction alert. Are you ready to bid?
Thank you, Ben. I loved you at Mad Men Superstore. And yes, it's true. I donated most of my exorbitant hosting fee back to the zoo so they could pay off some of my hair and makeup costs. What can I say? I give back. This has been a challenging year for everyone, except maybe for the langurs here at the zoo, who honestly have it pretty good. But if you're not a langur, and let's be honest, so few of us are, and you want a luxury escape, then bid on our first auction item, a stay at the brand new Four Seasons Resort Tamarindo, part of a secluded nature reserve on Mexico's Costa Alegre, where verdant jungle meets the Pacific Ocean. During your three-night stay for two in a gorgeous beach room view, you can enjoy the ocean and lush natural greenery, three pool areas, four restaurants and bars, a championship golf course, and fitness center. Also, I hear their towels are like super soft. Then closer to home, you'll get an exclusive look at one of Costa Alegre's native species, the magnificent jaguar, which is way more impressive than America's native Jacksonville jaguar. With a visit to the LA Zoo's own jaguar habitat, you can take part in a special morning feeding. And then, since watching a wild predator tear apart an animal carcass will stoke your appetite, enjoy breakfast in the rainforest of the America's Stilt House. For more details, excuse me, and to place your bid, check out item number one and to at the live auction category in the at bidpal.net/beastlyball. All right, I'm going to talk about a few items that people should be bidding on. Item 806, that's the ghost tour with LA Zoo registrar Chris Willis. Is it Chris? Find out if the zoo is haunted. I think the flamingos are. Just look at their eyes. Okay, we've got no bids on three beautiful photos from photographer Maggie West. So please, bid now. Please, bid now. So let's, okay, so remember, just keep on bidding on our online auction. What am I supposed to do to tell you how much we've raised so far? How much have we raised so far? Let's see. $811,866. That is great, you guys. We are on our way. I need you to keep bidding, please. Thank you so much for those who have bid so far. Keep bidding, and maybe, just maybe, you guys, you can take home this beautiful painting that I've painstakingly created throughout tonight's show. And now, to inspire the artist inside you, let's watch a legendary band perform their chart-topping cover of Toto's Africa. Please welcome Weezer, everyone. Weezer.
Hey, Los Angeles, and everyone at the Beastly Ball. We're Weezer saying thanks for your support tonight on behalf of wildlife and our planet. This one is for you.
I hear the drums echoing tonight. She hears only whispers of some quiet conversation. She's coming in 12:30 flight. Moonlit wings reflect the stars that point me toward salvation. I stopped an old man along the way, hoping to find some old forgotten words or ancient melodies. Turn to me as if to say, hurry boy, she's waiting there for you. Gonna take the line to drag me away from you. There's nothing that a hundred men no more could ever do. I bless the rains down in Africa. Gonna take some time to do the things we never. We'll be right back.
dogs cry out in the night as they grow restless, longing for some solitary company. I know that I must do what's right, as sure as Kilimanjaro rises like Olympus above the Serengeti. I seek to cure what's deep inside, frightened of this thing that I've become. It's gonna take a lot to drag me away. The rains down in Africa. Gonna take some time to do the things we never
Evans of the LA Kings. You may remember me from the storied Miracle on Manchester, where I scored the game-winning goal in overtime to complete the greatest comeback in NHL playoff history. Tonight, we need your support to help the LA Zoo make their own big comeback from this challenging year. So please bid in the auction, purchase and adopt an animal package, or just give what you can to help the zoo. Remember, we're all in this together. Thanks for all your support, and go Kings!
What do animals eat? Just ask Beth.
Do some animals eat watermelon?
Oh, yeah. Lots of animals love watermelons.
What do koalas eat?
Koalas eat leaves, too. They eat only eucalyptus leaves, so they have to have eucalyptus trees so they can get their leaves.
Do sloths eat ice cream?
Oh, sloths do not eat ice cream.
Do animals brush their teeth?
Oh, some. They don't brush their own teeth, but we do brush some of their teeth. So they're all trained like the gorillas will open their mouth up, and then the keepers can brush their teeth.
Hi, I'm Jimmy Kimmel. At the zoo, you know me as the guy who got his arm stuck in the vending machine outside the Gorilla Grill. But my family and I love the LA Zoo. It is a wonderful place to visit. It's one of the few places where you can eat funnel cake in front of a monkey. And your support goes to important conservation programs, animal enrichment programs, getting some sick new rims for the tram, and making sure that Matt Damon never buys the LA Zoo. That is what's most important. Thanks for all you do with the zoo, and thanks to everyone watching and supporting too.
Hi everyone, my name is Cindy Sheehan, we are Mariachi
Diva!
We think of a zoo, we hear this.
And now, another animal ambassador moment.
I would love to introduce you guys to Pixie Sticks. Pixie Sticks is our Cape porcupine here on our ambassador team. And Pixie Sticks was actually born right here at the zoo. So Cape porcupines are native to South Africa, and they are actually the largest species of porcupine. Pixie is a huge part of our ambassador program, and she is actually trained to step up and into a harness, and then she can go on walks around the zoo to meet people, to enrich other animals, and as well as enriching herself. So right now, she's eating some of her very, very favorite snacks, which are walnuts and peanuts and all the nuts, basically. So every morning, Pixie Sticks has a routine. We'll come in and feed her and give her enrichment and do a training session. Once a week, she participates in her own husbandry by stepping up onto a scale voluntarily so we can weigh her. And we're also working on a voluntary injection behavior and other voluntary behaviors that allow our vet staff to do all the care that they need on our animals. Completely voluntary and hopefully stress-free. I really hope that Pixie Sticks inspires you as much as she inspires me, as she is a perfect example of all the great work that zoos do, as she was born here as part of our Species Survival Plan, or SSP, and so that we can have a very healthy population of Cape porcupines under human care and learn all that we need to do so we can support the species in the wild.
Hey there, all you beastly ballers. Rain Wilson here. Now, what kind of world would it be if we didn't have anything to look at but ourselves? Blah. That is a scary thought and one I don't really want to contemplate. So, thank you so much for showing up tonight to support the work the zoo does to increase the biodiversity of our planet. Fact. Did you know that without the LA Zoo's breeding and release programs that there would be no California condors left? That's a fact. Another important fact is they can't do it without your help. So thank you. You may have just saved an endangered frog's life tonight. Man, I love frogs. Sorry.
Hey, what's up, you guys? Gabriel Fluffy Iglesias here. That's right. Fluffy, like one of the animals at the Los Angeles Zoo. See what I did there? So they gave me a piece of paper so that I make sure that I hit my right points. Otherwise, I go off on a tangent. Tangent, I just found that word out today. I have white friends that use words like tangent. So yeah, paper. So they wanted to know which one was my favorite animal. My favorite animal, there's so many awesome animals out there. I'm gonna go with a koala. And the reason why I like the koala is because the koala hangs out in a tree sleeping for 22 hours out of the day. That's right, 22 hours out of the day, that little fella likes to sleep. So thank you to everybody watching for your support here tonight. And we want to make sure that the LA Zoo can continue. It's essential conservation work for all of us. Thank you so much for taking the time to watch me. God, I miss performing. See you guys later. Yay, koala.
Hey, this is Vince Neil here. Man, the zoo, the LA Zoo, I have the best memories of being there when I was a kid and taking my grandkids there. You guys are amazing. And for everybody out there, please give generously to help these animals out here. And they really need it, and they'll appreciate it. So will I.
The Return of Earth, She by Christopher D. Sims.
I want my Earth back. I want my Earth back. I want to take each of our solutions, then share them through distribution. We all have effective contributions. We need to turn our passion into action, execution, drum circles, live spoken word theater, or civil disobedience, uniting as one, getting arrested. We are all a collective that can't be defeated, that can't be defeated, that can't be defeated. Immediate action is needed, is needed, is needed, is needed. What about our children? What about future generations? Who is going to save the lungs of the ecosystem? Who is going to save the lungs of the ecosystem? Toxic water slaughters the frogs and the fish. Imagine how much they wished we didn't pollute their habitats. Clean water, clean air. Imagine that. I want my Earth back. I want my Earth back. We need our Earth back. She returns. We need our Earth back. It is her turn. It is her turn. It is her turn. The return of Earth, she, the Earth has returned. She is living, breathing, realizing her breath was leaving, leaving. She was needing for us to remember her worth, to recognize her worth all over again, all over again. We used to be her friends. We used to help her heal us, help her heal us. And then she lost all trust and faith in us. She lost all trust and faith in us. She has returned mad, sad, and mad, sad. And however, she's empowered by this new commitment we are signing on to, that we are signing on to. She wants you, me, and the rest of the human beings who populate this planet to never take her for granted again, to never take her for granted again, to never take her for granted again. If she is dying, then who wins? If she is dying, then who wins? If Earth is dying, who wins?
Good evening. I'm Dr. Dominique Keller, Chief Veterinarian and Director of Animal Wellness Programs at the Los Angeles Zoo. 2020 opened the eyes of the entire world to the basic reality that humans and animals around the world are interconnected. The public was overwhelmed by a barrage of new terms like pandemic, cross-species transmission, and zoonotic disease. These are complex topics. They don't fit nicely into a two-minute television news story, but they actually do fit into what we do here at the Los Angeles Zoo. Because of our public and private supporters, the zoo is part of a worldwide continuing research on wild animals and their environments. As chief veterinarian at the zoo, I try to see the pandemic as an opportunity to share this research and educate people about an idea that is actually very familiar to us in the veterinary field, which is the concept of One Health. The Centers for Disease Control describes One Health as an approach that recognizes that the health of people is closely connected to the health of animals and our shared environment. So what about wild animal health is so important to the One Health concept? Well, the reason the word zoonosis has become so familiar to us this past year is because the risk of disease emergence increases when ecological or socioeconomic forces push human encroachment into wildlife habitat. Biologists, veterinarians, physicians, and others work full-time in the wildlife health and disease fields to better understand the impact of the intersection of humans and wild animals on global public health. Both by working with animals in their native environments and in managed cares, zoos such as ours are making valuable contributions to One Health. Los Angeles Zoo is not just a place where people can come to see and learn about wildlife, but as part of our conservation mission, we're actively engaged and work locally and around the world at that intersection of wildlife and human health. One Health, it's what we do here at Los Angeles Zoo and who we are. And we can't do it without you. Now you're gonna hear about an amazing opportunity to embrace your own good health, and my friend Joel McHale will tell you all about it.
Auction alert. Auction alert.
That's right. If you assumed we were done with luxurious auction items or that the zoo would find a different host for this event, boy, were you mistaken. Our next auction item is Escape to Lanai, an island sanctuary like no other, and relax at the Four Seasons Resort Lanai and Sensei Lanai, a Four Seasons Resort. This package for two includes a four-night stay at Four Seasons Lanai and a five-night optimal wellness program at Sensei Lanai, an amazing spa and one of the most gorgeous places on Earth to be wrapped, dipped, cracked, and rubbed. The five-diamond Four Seasons Resort Lanai is located on the southeastern coast of the pristine Hawaiian island of Lanai, of course, moments away from many of the most scenic spots. Spend your days lounging by lagoon-style pools, strolling botanical gardens, reconnecting body and spirit at the spa, and savoring Japanese cuisine at cliffs. Just wait for you. Something's coming up, guys, at the Nobu Lanai. And for an unforgettable experience, take me along with you because this honestly sounds super, super nice. At Sensei Lanai, a Four Seasons Resort, experience an adults-only, yeah, luxury wellness enclave where you'll receive a private wellness consultation and an itinerary personalized just for you with a choice of spa treatments, fitness classes, and enriching island activities, as well as dining by Nobu. Included is round-trip airfare from Honolulu to Lanai Air, operated by Western Aircraft Incorporated. And for that hint of luxury, I'll have my brother Steven drop you off at the airport. Honestly, this sounds like a delightful and restorative trip that any of us could use after this past year, especially me. So please, please take me with you. For more details and to place your bids, check out item number 2 in the live auction category on bidpal.net/beastlyball2021. You've been hearing a lot about California condors all night, so I think it's time to introduce to you a very special guest, Hope the California Condor. Yeah, look at that. Look, being in the same space as this magnificent creature really underscores the majesty of wild animals and makes me wish I didn't handle all that raw meat before tonight's show. Hope, which is short for hope she doesn't maul me with her talons tonight, is an ambassador from the zoo's Angela Collier World of Birds show. Hope debuted as the first California condor to participate in a free-flight naturalistic bird show when a wing injury made her ineligible for release in the wild, which is the same thing that cut short my once promising career in competitive gymnastics. Since she joined the show, Hope has given guests a bird's eye view. Oh, I just got that. Okay. Yeah, that's great. Okay. Of the California condor, a critically endangered species that the LA Zoo helped bring back from the brink of extinction. And while Hope's home here at the zoo tonight can bring home, oh wait, I said that all wrong. And while Hope's home here at the zoo tonight, you can bring home a hope of your own. There, see, there it is. And it's an adopt package. You can bring home this version, priced at $100. This year's Beastly Ball Adopt Package includes a personalized adult certificate, a photo fact sheet of your adopted animal, a window decal, and your choice of a 12-inch plush animal, which, unlike its real-life counterpart, requires, whoa, way less raw meat to feed. Adopts are fully tax-deductible. Score. You hear that, Hope? That's why I knew you'd be excited. And the proceeds support more than 40 international conservation projects in which the zoo participates, helping to save rare and endangered species. Let's check in with our fundraising total so far. Hope, would you like to say the amount? Just swing the camera over there, Dan. Swing it over. There's Hope. She's still there. Dan, you Hope, you want to say something? Go ahead. Okay. Sorry, Hope. I see. You're offended. That's right. So what have we raised so far? Let's see it. $848,826. Thank you so much. That is impressive. Very impressive. Right, Hope? Uh-huh. Okay. So keep bidding on all the auction items and donating. And now for another one-of-a-kind music performance with their rendition of the Jimi Hendrix classic, Fire. Please welcome a slew of rock legends: Slash from Guns N' Roses, Phil Collin of Def Leppard, Robert DeLeo of Stone Temple Pilots, Forrest Robinson of Delta Deep, and on backing vocals, Hope of the California Condors. Take it away, guys. Thanks, Hope.
Good job. Hey, guys, we're about to have immense fun. Welcome to the Beastly Ball.
Yeah. Carolyn Hennessy, back with you again, wondering why you have not bid yet. That's right, I'm looking at you. Yeah, you. No, you know who you are. And you know what you're wearing, because I can see you. So dig deep. Bid, bid again, and then bid some more. Because these are items you know you want to have. More importantly, the money that is coming from you all is going to help the programs here that help the animals at the zoo. I mean, local, international, on a regional level, across the United States. What they are doing with their preservation and conservation programs just cannot be matched, but they can only do it with your help. So bid. That's right, I'm looking at you. You.
Hello, I'm Nick Scott with the LA Rams. I love going to the LA Zoo, particularly to see the bighorn sheep. The zoo is the only place in the city where you can get close to the animals from all over the world. Did you know that connections with nature have been shown to improve physical, mental, and emotional health of humans? So bid in the auction, make a donation, and visit the zoo. You might see me there.
Carrots? Just ask Beth.
Hi. Hi, Beth.
Kainalu, do you have some questions about animals today?
What do baby elephants eat?
They eat milk. They have milk from their mothers. And then after they grow up a little bit, they'll eat hay at the zoo and maybe some carrots and some apples.
Some carrots.
Yeah. And some carrots. Do you like carrots?
Yeah. I'm going to give them two carrots. I got some carrots to eat. Baby elephants go to nap and then cut them off. And then carrots as milk. And then the carrots cook. And the carrot cooks.
Giraffes also like carrots, and they get frozen popsicles with carrots in them when it's hot in the summertime.
I think you have time for maybe just one more question, Lulu. Is there anything else you want to ask?
How about a baby elephant eat carrots?
Okay, we're going to not talk about carrots anymore. We're going to talk about something else.
How about carrots?
Bye.
Bye. Hey, you. Have you been on the silent auction yet? Go! I think we can all admit that it's been a very wild year, and the zoo could certainly use our support. And the silent auction is the most fun, awesome way to do that. So many good things up for auction. So go. Bid.
Hi, everybody. Me again, Charlie Kuntz, LA Zoo Ambassador. And my most memorable, life-changing experience at the LA Zoo would have to be that one time that I fell into the bear pit. No, I'm sorry. I didn't actually fall into the bear pit. Sorry for startling anybody out there. My bad. My most memorable experience was actually going behind the scenes to meet Rhonda the Rhino before she passed away. R.I.P. We'd love you very much. Getting to have that experience feeding apples, feeling her hide, and getting to look into her eyes and feel her unbelievably powerful, strong presence, and also the soulful existence that she had was really quite moving and a very, very surprising jolt of life that I could not be more appreciative of. Miss Rhonda, very, very much. It's donations like yours that are going to help us get through this wild time and help all of our animal friends, the ones that change our lives and touch our souls in the ways that they do. Rhonda has become somewhat of a spirit animal for me, so I think of her often, and that is truly one of the most amazing experiences of my life. So thank you, LA Zoo. I hope you're all having an excellent time. I hope you're bidding on the silent auction, and I hope that we are making new memories, and hopefully we can all be together again soon. So cheers.
And now, one more animal ambassador moment.
This is Remy. Remy is an American badger, and Remy actually came to us in a really strange way. So Remy is from Idaho originally, where somebody found him, and they actually kept him as a pet. Any target? Good. Now, you might imagine that badgers don't make great pets, and that's because they don't. So Remy was actually brought to us to live. Very good, Remy. That's a station. Now, badgers are a large carnivore. They eat mostly meat with some produce, so I'm technically kind of an omnivore. There you go. And they are a burrowing animal. So Remy would spend most of his time in the wild digging, and now his keepers spend most of their time filling holes. So now Remy has a fantastic job helping to educate people about the importance of respecting wildlife and giving them their distance. Ha, Remy.
Hello, everybody. I am Marcela Celorio. I am the Consul General of Mexico here in Los Angeles. I am visiting the Los Angeles Zoo, and now I am here with the Peninsular Pronghorn, the Berrendo Peninsular, Los Antílopes, known as the Ghost of the Desert. And I am amazed of the good collaboration that exists between this zoo, Los Angeles Zoo, and Baja California, and all the effort that they are doing, and all the help that the zoo has been providing for them, for these wonderful species, these beautiful animals to exist. So I want to thank to the zoo for all this endeavor, and I also want to thank all the Angelino community for the support to the zoo and these animals. Thank you so much.
Hi, I'm Jessica McNamee. As a Native Australian, I wanted to share a fun fact with you tonight about one of our Indigenous animals. Did you know that the Perenti is the largest monitor lizard native to Australia and the fourth largest living lizard on Earth?
Hi, it's Oral Hershiser, and the Los Angeles Dodgers are very proud to be helping out the Los Angeles Zoo. It's a fantastic opportunity, and you've got a great auction item coming up right now. You're able to play on the Dodger Stadium field to play softball. So you've got to really bid this one up and help the zoo.
Auction alert. Auction alert.
As Oral was just saying, this is an experience that previously was available only to those who could scale the razor wire fences at Dodger Stadium, the chance to play softball on the same field as the World Series champion LA Dodgers. Two teams of 15 players each will play up to 3 hours of softball at the infield of Dodger Stadium. Please, no spitting. The teams will get a chance to sit in the home and away dugouts and discover what they smell like. Each player will be able to bring one guest to watch the game from the field level stands, which means that's up to 60 guests will be able to participate in this once in a lifetime experience. And to complete your genuine Dodger Stadium experience, guests can leave in the middle of the fifth inning to try and beat traffic. For more details and to place your bids, check out item number 3 in the live auction category on bidpal.net/beastlyball2021. We have had a lot of bids tonight on a lot of different items. There are some items that have no bids as well. But there is one item. It's 532. It's a very hot item. Pizza party with Lance Bass and Pauly Peretti at the LA Zoo. And I understand there will be some Parmesan thrown in. Amazing. Also, check out the items with no bids, as I just said, because you could get an amazing deal. Go ahead and do that now. Don't you think so? Hope the Condor, she's gone. And don't forget, I've been creating a one-of-a-kind painting during tonight's show, also available in the auction. And once I sign the painting, its value will automatically increase by $15, which is what I charge for all autographs, even for small children. Although I'm not a trained artist, I think you'll agree this is the finest piece of original art by a clip show host ever commissioned for a zoo. I'd like to take some time out from transforming the entire concept of fine art to thank all of tonight's incredibly generous supporters, which includes all event patrons and donors. Children's Hospital LA, thank you. Welk Resorts, thank you. City National Bank, Alta Adams, Imagery Estate Winery, Liars Non-Alcoholic Spirits, and John Kelly Chocolates. And now let's check in with tonight's fundraising total so far. What do we have? $890,971. Please keep donating, everybody. We would love to beat last year's total. I was talking to Kevin the Peacock before the show, and he said we wouldn't be able to break the $1.2 million goal that we have. So come on, prove Kevin wrong, everybody. By the way, there are actually 5 Kevins here at the zoo. It's a lot of Kevins. And speaking of consummate showman named Kevin, let's enjoy a special guest performance by a true rock legend from REO Speedwagon. Please welcome Kevin Cronin.
Hi, everybody. Kevin Cronin from REO Speedwagon here, joining you from the LA
Zoo's
virtual beastly ball. We are coming together tonight to raise money to help the zoo help save animals from extinction. Now, I have raised 5 children over the years here in Los Angeles, and I've always found the zoo to be a great day. Just wonderful, educational, fun, affordable, just a great family day. So I'm a fan of the LA Zoo, always have been. That's where I'm here. I'm going to be singing a couple songs for you momentarily to help motivate you to dig into your pockets and make a generous donation, bidding on some of the wonderful items in the silent auction. So thank you for being here. I appreciate it. We all appreciate it. LA needs the zoo. The zoo needs you. And here's a couple of songs that you might recognize. Like, come on, let's go inside and give a listen. Woo! Play a song for you called Roll with the Changes.
As soon as you are able, woman, I am willing to make the break that we are on the brink of. My cup is on the table, my love is spilling, just waiting here for you to take and drink of. So if you're tired of the same old story, oh, turn some pages. I'll be here when you are ready. Gonna roll with the changes. Oh, yeah. You keep on rolling. Keep on rolling. Oh, roll with the changes. Keep on rolling. Keep on rolling. Oh, now roll with the changes. I knew it had to happen, felt the tables turning. You got me through my darkest hour. I heard the thunder clapping, and I felt the desert burning. Until you poured on me like a sweet sun shower. But if you're tired of the same old story, oh, baby, turn some pages. And I'll be here when you are ready. Gonna roll with the changes. Baby, roll with the changes. Oh, now you know, you know, you know you've got to keep on rolling. Keep on rolling. Whoa, now roll with the changes. Yeah, yeah, keep on rolling. Keep on rolling. Oh, and now roll with the changes. Oh, baby, keep on rolling. Keep on rolling. Oh, and now roll with the changes. You gotta keep on rolling. Keep on rolling. Boy, you got to keep on rolling, yeah. Everybody gotta keep on rolling. Whoa, oh yeah. Everybody got to keep on rolling with the changes. Thanks, everybody.
In the summer of 1980, I was going through kind of a tough time, and for me, usually the best songs come from the toughest times. And I woke up about 4 a.m., stumbled into my home studio, and this next song appeared.
should have seen by the look in my eyes, baby, there was something missing. Should have known by the tone of my voice, maybe, but you didn't listen. You played dead, but you never bled. Instead, you laid still in the grass, all coiled up in his sand. Though I know all about those men, still I don't remember. 'Cause it was us, baby, way before them, and we're still together. And I meant the word I said when I said that I love you. I meant that I love you forever. And I'm gonna keep on loving you, 'cause it's the only thing I wanna do. I don't wanna sleep, I just wanna keep on loving you. And I meant every word I said when I said that I love you. I meant that I love you forever. And I'm gonna keep on loving you, 'cause it's the only thing I wanna do. I don't wanna sleep, I just wanna keep on loving you. Keep on loving you. Thanks, everybody. Pleasure being with you.
Hi, I'm Lauren Ash. If you haven't bid in the silent auction yet, what are you thinking? Get over there. Make your bids. New this year is the art auction. This is so exciting, and it all goes towards helping saving animals from extinction. So what are you thinking? Go. Make your bids. Bid.
And now it's time to fund a need.
Each year we identify special needs that will benefit the health and well-being of our animals. This year we have four incredible opportunities, and we can really use your help in getting them funded. From medical equipment to a first-time ever new habitat, here are members of the Los Angeles Zoo staff to tell you more about these specific needs.
Hi, I'm David D'Souza, registered veterinary technician here at the Gottlieb Animal Health and Conservation Center. As a part of the healthcare team here at the Los Angeles Zoo, this autoclave is integral to everything that we do. The way the autoclave works is it uses superheated steam to sterilize surgical instruments, implants, and even substrate for some of our smaller patients here. This autoclave here is really, really old and non-functional. Most of the components for this autoclave are obsolete. As a top-notch facility, we really need to have cutting-edge technology, especially with our autoclave. And we'd love to kick this old dinosaur down the road, so we ask for your help in helping us to get a new autoclave. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Mike Bona, a member of the animal care team. There is no animal as iconic as the giraffe. This majestic species is one of our visitors' favorite stops in the zoo. The Los Angeles Zoo's giraffe exhibit is due for an update, and while giraffes often live in arid environments, here in Los Angeles, we want to provide our herd with some extra shady space in their habitat. We plan to provide over 300 square feet of shade cloth supported by naturalistic pole trees. Your support tonight will provide the needed funds to make the shade structure a reality and provide an area for our giraffes to have a break from the hot Los Angeles sun.
Since 2007, we have been working behind the scenes to reproduce the Southern Mountain Yellow Lake Frog, Rana muscosa, one of the most endangered amphibians on Earth. The ultimate goal has been to release our zoo-bred specimens back to their historic mountaintop ranges throughout Southern California. To date, Los Angeles Zoo has released thousands of mountain yellow lake frogs back to the canyons where they once lived. All of this work is done in a biosecure building, separate from all other amphibians in the zoo collection. But now, with the approval of our state and federal partners, we are going to be authorized to display mountain yellow lake frogs for the first time at the Los Angeles Zoo lair. Here's an opportunity to help fund this new and exciting display for one of California's most endangered animals, and thank you again for all of your support.
Hello, I'm Dr. Kathleen Cox, Director of Research here at the Los Angeles Zoo. My team and I are research scientists, and we're always collecting data to better understand the animals in our care. As scientists, we look for patterns of behaviors and ways in which the animals interact and respond to their surroundings. The data we record and collect informs recommendations on diet, enrichment, social environment, and the overall health of the animals. Having 8 new iPads will allow us to streamline data collection and enable us to make regular welfare assessments that can be quickly and accurately stored and easily retrieved. This data is critical as we track changes over time, and it is instrumental as we continuously strive to improve animal welfare here at the Los Angeles Zoo. Hope you can help us out.
Everyone, those fund and need projects are vital to the LA Zoo's amazing work, so please give all you can. So far, we have raised, what have we raised? $929,011. So please, guys, keep donating. We're reaching the end of our show. Stop clapping. But there's still time to bid on all of the auction items, so continue bidding to win one of those amazing experiences, and definitely bid if you want to take home this. It's a breathtaking original painting that I have been personally crafting all evening. And now I'm ready to share my astounding creation with all of you. Ready? There it is, guys. Yep. Right there. Please bid on this. It's a one-of-a-kind opportunity to tell guests in your home, see that thing? It was painted by the guy from Spy Kids 4. Incredible. See that? Yeah, just Tom. It's Tom's shirt. I don't know what's going on, why he wears it every year, but it is terrifying. And now, so please go bid on this, guys. This is what it looks like. It really does. Now, before we wrap things up, we have a few more messages from our sponsors. And after that, we'll hear from our conservation hero honorees. So please keep watching. Please keep watching. Please.
Hey, guys, Polly Perrette here. We all love our LA Zoo. I sure do. And being able to go and visit and interact with all the animals. But did you also know there's a lot more going on? Los Angeles is the main port for animals being brought into the United States and one of the main ports for the illegal wildlife trade. So the LA Zoo has worked for a long time with the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service to monitor these ports and monitor LAX to make sure that we can take care of these animals, and especially getting them out of the illegal wildlife trade. And our zoo experts can identify them and care for them and give them a quarantine space so we can get them eventually to a loving and safe forever home. Thank you for your support of the LA Zoo.
Kids ask the best questions. Just ask Beth.
Do animals dream?
I think that animals dream. Sometimes if you watch, like I watch my dog and it seems like she's running in her sleep or she's barking in her sleep. And I've seen orangutans kind of talk in their sleep. So I think they dream. Do you think animals dream?
Well, I think so.
Do you have any unicorns at the zoo?
Oh, well, unicorns are magical and you know they're very hard to see, right? So you will have to come to the zoo and look around and tell me if you find any unicorns.
What kind of snake is this?
I don't know. I'd have to see its head. Let me see its head. Oh, gosh. Maybe a cobra?
It looks like a poison snake because poison is green.
Why haven't you bid? Why haven't you bid? I'm dying over here. Why haven't you bid? Especially for the art auction. It's new. It's fabulous. There's some amazing treasures you can find. Don't make me come through this lens and into your pockets, because I will find you. I will dig deep for you. Don't make me do that. Reach down deep. Find some spare shekels. Come on. You know you want to. Please. Just...
A special message from Beastly Ball program sponsor, Children's Hospital, Los Angeles.
At Children's Hospital, Los Angeles, every team member comes to work with a single goal, to build healthier futures for children. Here, the finest minds in medicine come together to advance care and discover cures to benefit children. Our caring, committed team members work tirelessly to turn healthcare into health transformation for every child. Children's Hospital Los Angeles, the place families have counted on for generations.
Good evening, I'm Councilmember Nithya Raman, and I have the great honor of representing the people and institutions of Council District 4. While I'm one of the newer members of the Los Angeles City Council, I've long been a proud resident of this great district that is home to so many of LA's most treasured cultural institutions, including the LA Zoo, located in one of the nation's most beautiful and largest urban oases, Griffith Park. Los Angeles has so many unique experiences to offer its diverse communities, and the LA Zoo takes great pride in being a place that takes care of animals from all over the world and a place that welcomes people from all over the world. I am so proud of the zoo's commitment to diversity, to equity, to inclusion, to access and justice, and to fostering an inclusive and accessible experience for all visitors. You will learn more about these important initiatives throughout this evening. I also wanted to thank the outstanding leadership of Denise Verrett, CEO and Zoo Director, and Tom Jacobson, President of GLAZA, and urge you to participate in the celebration by bidding in the auction, making a donation, and supporting the zoo's special Fund Animal Needs opportunities. This is the zoo for all Angelenos, and tonight we need your support to create a better future for wildlife in our own backyard and around the world. Thank you.
If you haven't started bidding on the live auction yet, get going. There are incredible, one-of-a-kind items to choose from, and new this year is the art auction. I have my eye on the Mike Myers landscape. So let's go. Bid, bid, bid.
Hi, I'm Dr. Jake Owens, Director of Conservation, and tonight I'm incredibly excited chapter in conservation at the Los Angeles Zoo. For the past 18 months, we've been developing the first comprehensive conservation strategic plan in our zoo's history. This plan reflects a renewed response to the global extinction crisis we face. But we recognize that there's no real divide between the human and natural world, and so our response to this crisis has to simultaneously work towards a more prosperous and equitable future for wildlife, humans, and the habitat we all rely on. As we develop new programs to protect and preserve biodiversity, we'll work to break down barriers that have historically limited engagement in careers in conservation, empowering communities, and co-creating just and equitable solutions for diverse groups of people. We're committed to being a zoo without borders, a zoo that lives and breathes beyond its Griffith Park location and embraces a vision that values not only wildlife, but people and communities around the globe and works to preserve and improve them. Throughout our history, we've collaborated with people around the world to enhance the conservation efforts for countless species. From the southern mountain yellow-legged frog here in the San Gabriel Mountains to Asian elephants in Cambodia and Sri Lanka. Our impact has been significant, but as the threats facing our world increase and our time to respond dwindles, we have to act more strategically and with an intentionality that best utilizes our unique attributes, our place in the world, and the communities that we serve. We're facing an unprecedented global extinction crisis, and the pandemic is a brutal reminder that we must change the ways we interact with the natural world and each other. We all have a role to play, and we can't do it alone. Each and every one of you can join us in this journey, whether it's starting small actions in your own home, joining us for hands-on conservation in Griffith Park, or supporting our global initiatives. As this great city's zoo, the LA Zoo and Botanical Gardens is committed to this change and dedicated to contributing our unique resources and expertise to our shared goal, a better future for all. And now I'm turning it back over to Tom Jacobson to announce this year's Conservation Heroes.
Jackie Chan, actor and LA Zoo ambassador, is a beloved, internationally renowned martial arts action hero who's appeared in more than 150 films. He's a keen philanthropist, a UNICEF Goodwill ambassador, and a Wild Aid ambassador, working tirelessly to champion charitable causes. Starting in 2014, Jackie began making a series of PSAs on illegal wildlife trafficking in pandas, pangolins, tigers, sharks, rhino horn, and elephant ivory. Jackie Chan understands the value of wildlife on our planet and has used his unique voice to make a difference. And now, a word from Jackie himself. Just a little over a year ago, the world watched in horror as Australia burned. The bushfires ravaged more than 46 million acres, destroyed thousands of homes, and claimed the lives of both humans and wildlife. When actor and activist Leila George learned about the destruction to her home country, she came to the LA Zoo and asked how she could help raise funds for bushfire relief and consciousness of the impact of climate change on our planet and our home state of California. With the LA Zoo acting as host, Leila brought legislators, conservationists, scientists, and activists together for an evening of provocative conversation and the music of animal enthusiast Shania Twain. And now, I am delighted to present Leila George.
Hi, Leila George here. It is so lovely and exciting to be honored for something that I believe in so much. Obviously, climate change is such a huge threat, and bringing awareness to it in relation to conservation, I think, is so important. And in 2019, 2020, it really hit me personally with the bushfires in Australia because, you know, that land and that wildlife, all those creatures are so important to me and my childhood memories. And for sure, the event that we had at the LA Zoo was only as successful as it was because of the endless help that we got from the Greater Los Angeles Zoo Association. I mean, it really would have been a little party in my backyard with some fairy lights if it wasn't for you. So thank you so much for that again. Shortly after that event, I went on to work for CORE, a disaster relief organization that quickly started working in COVID-19 testing and is now doing vaccinations. I was chief of staff to the CEO, Ann Lee, as she and I traveled around the US setting up COVID-19 testing sites. And I have to say that the most important thing that I learned from last year from doing that work with CORE and working with GLAZA at the zoo was just how unbelievably happy it makes me to help others, creatures, humans, everything. I mean, I've never felt so useful and so fulfilled in my whole life. So if you're not already doing something, give it a try, please. I promise it'll make you feel so good. So thank you again. Thank you, thank you, thank you to the Greater Los Angeles Zoo Association. Bye.
So weird. Hey, everybody, a sincere thanks and congratulations. I can do sincerity. I'm not kidding. Don't act so surprised. But really, congratulations to our conservation hero honorees. And now one final word from Denise and Tom and Tom's horrible shirt.
Denise, the bidding has gone crazy tonight. Between the silent, live, and art auctions, there are so many generous people here tonight. I just put in a bid on Mike Myers' landscape painting. I might even be willing to bid up to $1 million. Just a reminder, the silent auction will remain open until this Sunday, June 6th at 6 p.m. So bid big and often. In closing, I just want to say thank you, thank you, thank you on behalf of all of us who work so hard every day to save animals from extinction. We can't do this without you.
Tom, I'm just letting you know, I am going to outbid you on the Mike Myers painting. And yes, thank you to all who joined us this evening. Everyone here at the Los Angeles Zoo is working tirelessly to continue providing excellent care for our animals,
saving their wild counterparts from extinction, and providing a safe and welcoming place for our community to have a relationship with nature. It is your generous support through donations, being members, visiting the zoo, becoming volunteers, and participating in our events that allows us to be a vital resource in a world-class city. We can't thank you enough, and we can't do it without you. Have a great evening, and we hope to see you at the zoo soon.
Thank you so much, and good night.
Well, thank you, Tom and Denise. And Tom, that Austin Powers impression, I will take to my grave. Thank you. That was terrifying. Everyone, thank you for joining us for the Los Angeles Zoo's Beastly Ball. Thank you for being here. Our sincere appreciation to all who have donated tonight. Bidding on tonight's auction will remain open until 6 p.m. tomorrow. That's tomorrow, June 6th, Sunday, everybody. So please keep bidding on all the amazing items in the live, silent, and art auction. Thank you, everyone, for watching and for your continued support. We hope to see you soon at the zoo. Good night. Thank you so much to Hope. Kevin, shall we grab a beer? All five of them are here. See you next year, guys. Thanks for donating. Keep doing it. Bye.
Mon paradis, c'est Paris. Même quand il est gris. Des bords de Marne à la rue de Rivoli. Il y flotte un air de fête. Mon paradis, c'est Paris. Parfum de bohème anime les faubourgs. On s'encanaille, on s'aime, et jusqu'au petit jour. Belles gueules et garçons, poètes et dandys, on ne refuse personne, pourvu qu'on aime la vie. Mon paradis, c'est Paris. Même quand il
I'm Shatter Stevens. Thank you for watching and supporting your LA Zoo. You can continue bidding in the auction until 6 p.m. Sunday, June 6th. Have a good night.